A moment of drama at 1 a.m. as thousands file past the Queen's coffin. A guard collapses. Two Scotland Yard officers rush to help.
That fall was pretty brutal. It was a full face plant right on the ground. Could that have caused an injury?
Faints themselves are generally relatively harmless. If you're standing very still, particularly if your legs are locked and you're not really moving around, blood tends to pool in the lower parts of your body, and therefore not enough gets back to the heart, and critically, not enough gets back to the brain, and that's when you pass out.
It's reminding many of the moment King Charles III was also unsteady on his feet after walking for 40 minutes behind her coffin, then standing to attention in the hall. Charles had no public events today, but Prince William and Kate were out and about shaking hands with well-wishers. He stopped to admire a baby and spoke about his own children's reaction to the Queen's death.
He told a well-wisher that he found walking behind the Queen's coffin yesterday very difficult, and that it reminded him of all those memories of walking behind Diana's coffin 25 years ago when he was just 15. A very emotional day for William today.
But while William and Kate are winning hearts, King Charles is coming under fire from New York magazine's The Cut. The magazine, which recently ran a flattering cover profile of Meghan Markle, is calling King Charles a big, fussy baby and his reign of fussiness. The reason? Two flashes of temper involving, of all things, pens. He growled at an aide to remove a pen tray during one signing ceremony, and 2 days later stormed out after he stained his fingers with a leaky pen. In London, the steady stream of mourners filing by the Queen's coffin continues day and night. Inside Edition's Allison Hall is there.
All of these people who have been waiting in line for hours behind me to pay their respects to the Queen have to go through airport-style security, a metal detector, bag checks. They're not allowed to bring in food or water, and when they get inside, they cannot take any photos.
It's just part of a massive security operation underway for Monday's funeral.
It's the biggest security arrangement that this country's ever had for the Queen's funeral. It's unprecedented in scale.
These structures here are specifically designed so that no vehicle can get through to the crowd.
That's correct.
Meanwhile, Britain continues to mourn their...
For the royal family as Queen Elizabeth II left Buckingham Palace for the final time today. Her coffin was taken out of the palace and a procession took to the streets of London to Westminster Hall.
Yeah, members of the royal family came together to honor Her Majesty, including King Charles III, Prince William, Prince Harry, and Prince Andrew, who all walked behind the gun carriage.
And once inside Westminster Hall, William and Harry were joined by their wives, Kate Middleton and Meghan Markle, for the service and for the reception of the Queen's coffin, where it will lie until the date of her funeral on September 19th.
And in another touching moment, Harry is seen wiping away tears as Meghan stands beside him.
You know, when they're walking behind the coffin, I just can't think, help but think, how really hard that must be for William and Harry, given that when they were just young boys, they did the same for their mother. So having to do that again, I'm sure it's like it's triggering and it brings a lot of things back.
Although,
you know, she is at peace now and she lived an incredible life.
And it's funny you say that because Diana passed away September 6, 25 years ago. It's almost to that date where they're walking the same procession, the same way. So it is hard to watch. Even I was watching a glimpse of it today of how it's all being handled and people are scrutinizing the way, like, he's not wearing a military suit or whatever it is, but at this moment it's to celebrate the life of Queen Elizabeth. So
there's a lot of politics involved in everything with Andrew, everyone with the brothers
all
and their arguments, but at the end of the day, a family just lost someone that they love. Like at the very, at the core of it, they lost somebody that they love.
Yeah.
And everybody's mourning it and the whole world is watching, yeah. which is a lot of pressure.
It's a lot. They lost their grandma.
Estimated. Yeah. More than 1 million people will be paying their respects to Queen Elizabeth II as she lies in state right now at Westminster Hall.
Truly incredible numbers. Some mourners waited in line overnight to secure their spot. Once inside, they only have a few minutes to walk by the Queen's coffin. The Queen will lie in state until her funeral Monday, which will attract many high-profile guests, including President Biden and the First Lady. CBS News foreign correspondent Raimi Innocencio joins us from outside Westminster Abbey in London. Hi, Raimi. So what is the mood of the crowd now where you are as they prepare to pay their respects to the Queen?
Sure, Tanya. Well, I am right now just outside Westminster Hall, and you can probably make out some of the queue right behind me. The feeling among so many is very thoughtful and definitely very patient, as you were describing. People have been waiting several hours to overnight. But the people that I spoke to, thoughtful because everyone has a story as to what Queen Elizabeth meant to them, and especially if they actually even met her. Case in point, one man that I spoke to said that when he first met Queen Elizabeth, he actually didn't think he was a real person until he actually saw her. This was in university. But he just had to lay his eyes on her and say, wow, this person does exist, aspirational. She is kind. She is respectful. She is someone that we all want to strive towards. Another person that I spoke to said that she was like family. A grandmother, and the word grandmother's come up so many times. Of course, she herself was 96 years old. The country has grown up with her, aged with her, as she herself has done. Everyone here, very, very emotional, but also keeping it in. British folks here keeping a stiff upper lip. But when we spoke to them, some people did start to get a little emotional. Tears almost started to break off their face. I also spoke to the London mayor, Sadiq Khan. He just happened to be crossing the street as we were walking by, and I asked him what Queen Elizabeth meant to him. He said that he will remember her smile and the sparkle in her eye, and also said that even though she was someone who was so iconic, she also felt that he also felt that she was very close to family and also grandmother that would be very much missed.
So remarkable considering in just a few hours it will have been a full week since the news of the Queen's ill health and passing. Who else could get folks to line up in such a polite manner? But if there's one thing Brits know how to do, it's queue. Even when there's looting in London, they're queuing. But Raimi, tell me about the security posturing, because while people are mourning and grieving, you still have a lot of people densely located and moving through for the next few days. So tell us about the security status there.
Absolutely. People are calling this one of, if not the biggest security operation in British history. And of course, this is also the biggest state funeral that this country has also hosted. So they do go hand in hand. But we're seeing thousands of metropolitan police having been deployed. Not only that, they're also getting help from other cities. For example, earlier today, members of the Scottish police force also came in. So they're bolstering the thousands who are already on the street. Now, in terms of the potential threats, they range in everything that you would get from any major occasion that could be on the likes of pickpockets to protests and also, of course, terrorist activities. Thankfully, nothing like that has come up. But we do know that there are, for example, sharpshooters on some of the roofs around here. We did see policemen up on the roof of Buckingham Palace yesterday. In addition, many of the trash bins, they are actually anti-explosive. So, for example, if someone wanted to throw something in there to cause harm, those would actually more contain them. With that said, with millions of people trying to come in, people milling about, this operation can't be 100% safe. So the police are also saying, listen, all of you out there are also our eyes and ears. If you see something, like we say in New York, say something.
Yeah, and it does appear as if those lines are actually moving relatively quickly.
Yeah.
People are getting their opportunity to pay their respects. So hopefully that continues to be the case.
And I can imagine they're very polite about the amount of time they take when they actually get to the Queen's coffin.
Yeah, we can imagine.
Yes.
And we hope.
We hope.
Raimi Innocencio, thank you so much.